See, the graffiti in the gents has hit new heights of literacy.
Oh, yeah? What's the latest?
West Ham is a puff.
I don't know why we come in here. I should be in a wine bar.
Oh, it's local.
So's a sperm bank, Dermot, but I don't want to go drinking.
What's that with him?
His girlfriend won't talk to him.
Oh, tell everybody, why don't you? Let's put it on teletext.
Here, Liz, Gary's girlfriend won't talk to him.
She's seeing another bloke.
And she's seeing another bloke.
Shut up.
You tried ringing her?
Yeah, her mother's screening her calls. I tried pretending to be her friend Julie, but I couldn't do the Burnley accent.
Why don't you go to Casualty, talk to her there?
Nah, sod it.
Go on. You get to see some terrific injuries.
I've decided to switch my attention to Deborah.
Oi, I've already told you. I'm in love with Deborah.
Oh, you're always saying you're in love with people. You said it to Les once.
Yeah, well, I've been drinking.
Sexual problem, is it, you and your girl?
Dear God. No, we just had a slight misunderstanding, all right?
I've got this book. If you want, you can have a lend.
It's not a sexual problem, thank you very much. There's just a slight misunderstanding, that's all, thank you. Could we pay to get some of his glands removed?
As long as he doesn't put them in a jar by the till like when he had his gallbladder out.
Is that what that was? I nearly ordered that with a ploughman.
Listen, you don't want to give up on Dorothy.
Why not? We're always arguing.
Well, you're like Elizabeth Taylor and Richard Burton, aren't you? Only not as attractive.
Thank you.
Or interesting.
No, it's over between us. If she can throw herself at a knee surgeon, so can I. There's women everywhere just waiting for me. Well, not in here, obviously.
Yeah. You read what I wrote about West Ham in a car.
Nice one, Les, yeah.
Anyway, you're no good at chatting up women.
What do you mean?
Well, I remember at university you were still trying to impress them by showing them your pencil case.
It was a great pencil case.
You used to swan up to them at parties and say, "Evening, gorgeous." So how many O-levels did you get? Anyway, you can't go after Deborah. She's my woman.
Your woman? You only went out with her once and she called you a sad little man.
Yeah? Well, we're going to build on that.
You see, Deborah would be just right for me, living upstairs.
It's like you want a housekeeper, not a girlfriend.
I just want someone who's going to look at me every now and again and say, "Gary, you're a great guy."
Oh, right. So you want a housekeeper who's a congenital idiot.
Just put the record on, will you?
What do you want? Jim Reeves or the 1970 England World Cup squad?
No. Anything.
Someone been sick in the jukebox again?
Yeah, probably. It's got a nice ring to it, hasn't it?
What? Jim Reeves, the vomit megamix.
Gary and Deborah. Or Deborah and Gary.
Listen, I hardly think a girl of Deborah's sophistication is going to go after the grandmaster of sleaze and his sensational pencil case.
I've improved my technique since then, Dermot, as Deborah will find out.
That's all it was.
George, which one do you think's most likely to impress a young lady?
It's always difficult to say with burglar alarms. Mm. Maybe you ought to buy her something more feminine.
What, an ironing board, something like that?
Don't you think you ought to try to get together with Dorothy instead of chasing after other women with ironing boards?
No.
A marvellous girl, Dorothy. Lovely, sturdy neck.
To be honest, George, if you eat nothing but bananas for 2 years, you start to want grapefruit. Anyway, she's chosen to steer clear of me, so that's that, isn't it?
I remember the day after you first met her. You kept smiling. We all thought you'd done something to your mouth.
Let's see which one's got the best tone, shall we? Model number one.
Yes. It has a distinctive tone, doesn't it?
playing at?
Hello there, Anthea. What can we do for you?
Oh, I just thought I heard something.
Yeah, it's all right, Anthea. It's stopped now.
I feel a bit shaky.
Yes, well, perhaps you'd better have a lie down.
Hmm? Yes, I think I might.
Yes, next Thursday seems like a good time.
Marjorie says that the best defense against burglars is to shame them by putting out a plate of fancy biscuits. Of course, you have to know in advance when they're coming.
Right. Item 13 on the agenda. It's just after 12. Japanese-style nibble, Deborah?
No, thanks. I still have some here.
Ah, good.
Deborah and I will probably be going out for a meal later anyway.
Dermot, no.
Oh, right. Change of plan. How long is this residence meeting going on for anyway?
You don't have to stay if you don't want to, Dermot. Deborah and I have got important matters to discuss as property owners.
I own property.
I'm not talking about a scalectric set and some pants, Dermot. I'm talking about mortgage commitments. You're just a lodger. You don't even exist legally.
Oh.
Maybe we could skip this item here about what to do in the event of a terrorist siege.
Yeah, all right, yes.
If it happens, we'll just improvise, shall we?
Oh, good, good, good. So, security.
Oh, God.
Deborah, do you know the single most common cause of burglaries?
Burglars?
Yes. But try and think more conceptually.
Original sin?
Good, good, good. Now a little less conceptually.
Opportunity?
You had to call it out, didn't you? You had to spoil it.
Trying to hurry things along a bit.
You see, Deborah, your average burglar just can't resist an unguarded target. Oh, yes, yes, it is sad.
No, it's not that. You're leaning on my hair.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What about the burglar alarm on the front of the house?
It's an empty box. Somebody stole the real one.
Yes, well, I'm glad you brought that up, Deborah, because I bought us a little something for our house. Now, would you like to do the honours?
Oh, how thoughtful.
Oh, well, if you can't help out your special friends, what can you do, eh?
Oh, sorry. No.
So what's wrong with you? Dorothy.
Dermot, what are you doing here?
It's about Gary.
Gary.
You know, tall, fair-haired,
yes,
big ears.
Yes, thank you, I remember. Look, if you want to talk to me, you're going to have to give me a hand. We're short-staffed, as usual.
Well, I haven't really done much medical work before.
Don't worry, I'm not going to ask you to perform open heart surgery.
Oh, phew. The thing is,
why didn't Gary come in person?
He's a bit under the weather.
Lightning, hopefully. Dermot, help, will you?
Sure, what are we doing?
It's Gary's fault. He shouldn't take me for granted. I meet lots of very attractive men here.
Yeah, sure, but they're all, you know, bleeding and...
I've had a psychiatrist practically begging me to meet his mother. Then there's Graham. We're planning a weekend away together. On a barge.
Sounds like a bundle of laughs.
He's very considerate, actually.
Oh, I see. He's boring, is he?
No! No! Not always.
He's hardly Gary, though, is he?
Well, he doesn't buy all his clothes at Millett's, if that's what you mean.
I'm worried Gary will make a fool of himself over an unsuitable woman.
He already has. It was me. Dermot, we're making a bed, not applying gold leaf.
He's in a bit of a bad way.
Really? You send me a photograph.
He's pining for you. I heard him shouting out things about you in his sleep.
Oh, don't be stupid. What sort of things?
A lot of it's very sexual.
Doesn't surprise me.
So you'll get in touch with him then?
I'll think about it. Sexual things, you say?
Yeah. Yeah, I started to write them down, but, you know, scared someone find the piece of paper. Well, no, I'm sorry, you can't use this bed. We just made it.
It's not as easy as it looks, this, you know?
Why don't we just glue it on?
Hammer the gimlet, would you?
You want to put labels on them. Do you one of these long things with a sharp end. Should have got a professional in.
Well, I'm not afraid of manual labour. I installed those dimmer switches, didn't I?
And they don't actually dim, but...
Yes, they do. You just have to unplug the cooker.
Bumped into Dorothy yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
Said she was missing you.
Mm-hmm.
Seemed quite upset.
Fantastic. I mean that in a loving way.
Yeah, right.
Where did you bump into her?
In the bus.
What's wrong with her bike?
She's having the front basket really wicked.
Bit of a coincidence, isn't it? You two bumping into each other like that.
What? You reckon she's following me?
No, I reckon you're making it up to get us back together again.
No.
Leaving the way clear for you to pounce on Deborah.
You know you want to get back with Dorothy.
It's up to her. Anyway, when was the last time she showed me any affection?
Friday before last. Noise coming out of your bedroom sounded like you were castrating a pig in there.
It was a rhetorical question. Just hold the ladder, will you?
Hang on.
Dermot? Dermot!
For you.
If it's Dorothy, tell her I'm in the bath with the girl from the video shop.
It is Dorothy.
Oh. Did you hear me say what I just said?
No, but she just heard you say that.
I'll call her back.
Can he call you back? She says no, she's just about to have a torn sphincter on her hands.
Disgusting. Ask her how she is.
How are you? She says she's fine.
Ask her if she's got her bike back on the road yet.
She says she has.
This is ridiculous. Pass me the phone.
I can't put my finger on it, Dermot, but something's not quite right here, is it?
Hang on.
Yes. Yes. Well, it's a bit awkward now. Well, why don't you come round tonight? Anytime. Yes. All right. Bye.
You dropped some of your tools.
What do you think? Great, eh?
What does that yellow flashing light mean?
Police patrol car alerted. Oh, that's the other model.
That's the last thing we need. Police bursting in expecting cups of tea.
Yellow light, yellow light. I'll get back to you on that one, Deborah.
I don't suppose it's very important.
No, no, no.
Nor that blue one that's just come on.
That's probably to warn you that the yellow light's just come on.
right, excuse me, Deborah. Deborah, I'm going to call on you to open the door. Now, do you think you can manage that?
I think so, if you talk me through it.
Oh, right, so you're breaking into our flat.
Make sure you steal Gary's cravats.
You've already managed to break through the three locks on the front door, and now you're forcing your way in, so...
It's a quiet one, isn't it?
Shall I go in?
Oh, don't say I've got a faulty machine.
Maybe it's just warming up.
Shall I go in?
No! Oh, no.
No need to shout at Deborah.
No, it's all right. I probably just didn't open the door correctly.
No, no, you opened it really well. It's beautiful.
Shall I go and unplug the cooker?
I know what. Dermot, you open the front door.
Right, so I'm breaking out now, am I?
Yeah, all right, I think we get the picture. Ah. Great, eh?
Hey? With a hammer, Gary. I'd enjoy that.
I think I know what the problem is.
Yeah, the alarm's been stuck on for 3 hours.
Now, you see, it's got these mechanisms to stop me from shutting it off.
I thought you were supposed to know about alarms.
I'm a sales manager, Dermot, not a technician.
It's like in that film, 2001, isn't it? The machine's got a bigger brain than the man who installed it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me for making the effort. I suppose it's just the kind of person I am. Ah, well, it all looks pretty straightforward.
Gary, have you found a way to turn it off yet?
Turn it off? Yes, well, no problem. How did that happen?
Careful, those wires may be still live.
Gary? Gary? Oh, God, I think he's unconscious. Agga-doo-doo-doo, push pineapple, how are you? Agga-doo-doo-doo.
What are you doing?
I saw it in a film. You get them out of their coma by singing them their favourite song. To the left, to the right, jump up and down.
Thank you, Dermot. Thank you. I don't think I'm in a coma.
You've used the lights upstairs as well.
Right, now, look, walk this way.
I'm afraid I don't have any candles.
Then mine, you can share mine.
Thank you, Dermot.
It's all right. You can have them on your side of the bed.
Dermot, that's neither clever nor funny.
You never have a guide dog when you need one, do you?
Oh, Deborah, you must think I'm a complete fool.
Yes.
Careful, that match is burning down.
Ow!
Don't you have a torch?
Yes, but Dermot used the batteries in his novelty cocktail shaker. Now... Don't you worry, you're pretty... Ah! I'll just go and phone the electrician. Excuse me.
Let's have a bottle of wine to celebrate, eh?
Celebrate what?
Oh, I usually think of something after a couple of glasses. So, how's your boyfriend in Singapore, then?
Fine, thank you.
Does he work with dangerous machinery at all?
He says he'll come round when he's finished watching the snooker.
Oh, when does it finish?
A week on Sunday. I'll call another one in the morning. Dermot, can you go and get the spare candles out of the shed?
Get them yourself.
Oh, go on, Dermot. Don't be mean.
Excellent idea, Deborah.
So... How's your boyfriend in Singapore?
Why is everyone so interested in my boyfriend?
Well, you must get lonely up there on your own.
Sometimes. Mike won't be working over there long.
Mm. What is it he does?
He's an engineer.
Ah. Does he work with...
No, he doesn't work with dangerous machinery.
Oh.
So, about you and Dorothy... Last time I saw you both, you were shouting at each other.
Yeah, we've more or less split up, actually.
Oh, that's a shame.
Well, I suppose we were like a candle that had to go out. I got that from a book, actually.
Yes, I thought so.
You know, you've got just the right bone structure for your face. They're very important bones.
Yes. They stop my face from caving in.
Yes. I can't remember the last time I was intimate with a woman.
Weren't you intimate with Dorothy?
In a mechanical sort of way. I mean, she tried to excite me rather pathetically. And as I said to her, you just can't light a fire without a spark. Now you've moved in upstairs. And you've brought the candles and the matches with you, which is brilliant because they're just great in a power cut. Now, I know you want to talk, Deborah, but there's things I really must be doing. Oh, Dorothy. We're just talking about you. Oh, that's nice. Would you excuse me? I'll just go and put these in some water.
Couldn't find any spare candles, but I came across this old Shawaddy Waddy album. Great, eh? So, that's them paired off. Now it's just you, me, and the candlelight.
2 out of 3, Dermot.
You're right. Who needs candles? Oh!